quite a lot of power. And we'll explore some of that acceleration in just a moment, coming around this corner. So also on top of that, you can do what we call one pedal driving, or what is known in the world of EV. So I'm going to accelerate here, but also I'm going to come off the accelerator and let the car decelerate so I can make it around the corner. Hugs the corners. This particular model is the H-Track, so it's an all-wheel disc depending on the trim level you get. So if you get the two-wheel drive version of this with the extended range.
Well, the big trend, if you look around the New York Auto Show, is electrification. That's exemplified by all of the independent car makers that are trying to introduce electric vehicles, but also some of the major manufacturers. Like if you walk around here, you'll see Hyundai has a whole test track to drive their new IONIQ 5 electric car. Electrification is absolutely the hottest trend happening right now. Well, one of the big things that's happening is sort of a general move towards electrification. It's better for the planet, that kind of thing. But also, there's a real spike in consumer interest in electric cars right now because of rising gas prices. With an average price of over $4 a gallon in the United States right now, at Cox Automotive, we saw a 69% jump in interest in electric cars in March versus January. So people are really looking at their options so they don't have to burn down their entire budgets on gasoline.
We believe the future of EV technology is not going to be measured so much on the speed and performance, but much more on the processing power of the vehicle. So integrated within the Indy One is a supercomputer, which we refer to as the VIC, Vehicle Integrated Computer. And when you look under the hood of the Indy One, you will see the VIC represented there. So on top of that VIC, we're able to do social aspects with social content creation, capturing video and audio content with the cameras and microphones built into the car. We're able to upload those real time to the web for your social activities. Because it's a Windows-based computer, you're able to run any type of software for productivity or creativity within the vehicle to keep you busy and working while you're on the run. And also for us, we're able to build some amazing gaming experiences on top of that VIC computer.
Depending on time of year, but he was from Minsk. No, Pinsk, actually, sorry.
One thing we see at the New York Auto Show is that there are a lot of electric car startups, and each one of them is trying to distinguish its own vibe and establish itself as a unique entity, and everybody's looking for a little bit of a gimmick. One of them is Indy EV, and they've got a focus on gaming. They've got a supercomputer under the hood that you can use for gaming purposes. Whether that's really relevant to car shoppers or just a gimmick that entices investors remains to be seen. One thing we have seen, though, is it is very, very hard to build a car and sell it to the public, but it's very, very easy to build a concept and build some hype. So I guess we'll see how many of the car makers here actually go to production. So Chrysler is re-upping their interest in the electrified space. They introduced a vehicle called the Chrysler Airflow at CES this year, and they're reintroducing it here, which is sort of odd, with slightly revised styling. So this is an all-electric SUV that'll get somewhere between 350 and 400 miles of range. And normally you wouldn't update a concept car unless you had real intention to bring it to life. So it's pretty clear that Chrysler is interested in getting into the electric car game. But we'll have to wait a little bit because that's not going to arrive until 2025. The vehicles that I think are interesting this year are not electrified, which is kind of funny, but the Kia Telluride is being updated. And it's a really good example of the dichotomy we have where people are looking for more efficient choices and also people really want large SUVs. The Kia Telluride is a three-row midsize SUV, and it's still hugely, hugely popular. And they've updated it with new styling and bigger screens. And even though we want to do the responsible thing and use less gasoline, maybe go electric, our heart still wants to have big screens and room for our entire family and a big V6 engine and all the space we need to go live our active lifestyles. The Alfa Romeo Tonale is an interesting one because it kind of bridges the gap between what you want and what you need. So it's a new compact SUV that will be introduced. It starts going sale in about 2023, the first part of that. But what's interesting is that they're offering it with a normal 2-liter turbocharged engine, so it'll be fast and powerful and emotional. But they're also offering it as a plug-in hybrid version, which will get more than 30 miles of pure electric range. And really, that's where we see trends going, is this increased electrification, so we can enjoy our vehicles, but also do the responsible thing and burn a little less gas.